Welcome, darling. Welcome. Welcome, baby, to a sentimental channel, a kitchen sink waterer, an indoor grower, a place where you can frankly get your life orchids for dummies. This is Foul Pal Darrell. Welcome on back. Thank you so much for staying tuned. In today's video, darling, I want to educate you on what to look forward to in your Phalaenopsis orchid rebloom. I even want to give you a couple of care tips that will help you to get your first double spike. Okay, after you get your first rebloom, then you want to achieve to get a double spike, and even more after that. Stay tuned. Welcome all back. Thank you so much for staying tuned. So the first thing that you want from your Phalaenopsis orchid rebloom, okay, the first thing first is you want your Phalaenopsis to rebloom that is healthy, okay? You want at least 3 leaves on your orchid before it reblooms. You want to make sure that your orchid has beautiful roots, okay? That it is well established in the pot before it blooms, because blooming, if you did not know, could be a good thing and it could be a bad thing. Stay tuned back. This is what I meant right here. This beautiful, beautiful Phalaenopsis orchid right here, which is her first rebloom for me, she has bud blast. Bud blast is when the flowers will not open. You see how this orchid is open? The bud blast means that it will not form. You see this right here? This is green. This is a good bud. That is how we know it is going to open up, which is bloom. But this baby right here, oh no, 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 it's gonna fall off. It will never turn into this beautiful darling right here. Isn't she beautiful? She isn't fragrant, but she is very beautiful. But if you inspect the plant farther, you will see, Foul Pals, you will see it. This baby is dead and gone. She is dead and gone. Now, I don't want to mess with her too much because she would actually fall apart. But this is what I believe to be crown rot. Okay, it is gone. If I move it too much, it's going to die. But that's a whole different video. I just wanted to show you that when the Phalaenopsis orchid goes into spike, which is this orchid right here, it could be a good thing and it could also be a bad thing. Okay, so now we know the difference between a good Phalaenopsis in bloom or in spike versus a bad one. So the next thing is, how many buds do I want on my orchid spike? Well, there are different types of spikes. So to keep it short and keep it cute, I'm going to talk about the Phalaenopsis orchid hybrids. The ones that you get from the grocery store, like your Just Add Ice, or even the ones that you might have gotten for Valentine's Day or Mother's Day. Those blooms, you want at least 7 buds. Stay tuned. I will show you what I mean. Welcome on back, baby, where the humidity is low. And where when the humidity is low, the blooms will fade. The blooms will blast. Only in your strongest of orchids will they be able to tolerate it. Like this beautiful baby right here. Yes, God, honey. Yes, baby, I will not be able to put all of my beautiful Phalaenopsis orchids in that display because these are my big mama jamas and it's just hard to move them around. Some of them, like this one, I did not train the spike. I just let them do what they wanted to do. So I have to be extra careful, okay, to make sure that she is a happy camper, okay? So you want at least 7 buds. These little things right here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, now if you get anything over 7, that's a plus. But for your first rebloom, that's at least what you want. Now, sometimes you will get a rebloom off of an old flower spike. And sometimes you might get just only one bloom or one bud, such as this. Hey.